How to design a login form in Figma. I've got this website called Thumblytics and they're doing all sorts of cool stuff, but today we're going to be looking at their current login and seeing if we can improve it. I'm going to put it into Figma and we're going to play around with it using design thinking, UI, UX, and make it a little bit better. If you don't know who I am, I'm Adrian from Australia. I do videos around design and development, so if you haven't already, hit like and subscribe and we're just going to jump straight into it. We've got this login screen on Thumblytics, and if we test it out here and select login, we can see a couple of things happen. The first is that the input actually doesn't reach the very end of the screen. The input is actually sort of stuck here inside the screen. You don't actually notice this until you type in there. The other part is that it's a little bit confusing because you don't even know if this is actually a login or a sign-in or a register. This sort of says sign in to your account or register a new account. But normally when you do this, if you go to a login button, you'd expect a text that says here login, and maybe this could be subtext and a couple of other things that I can see here we can improve on. So let's jump into our Figma board and take a look. The first thing I'm going to do is maybe create a box in here. Normally when you have a login, you normally have an overlapping box that essentially provides the login section. And what I might do is I might copy this box out and create a second one underneath. And this one here might have that new primary color they're using. This is a pretty cool primary color and I quite like this. And what we could do now is we create some box shadow on this. Not too much, just a little bit to essentially show that there is some shadow happening. So usually what I like to do is about 12 pixels with about maybe 6 pixels offset. And we can do that around 12% maybe. So let's give that a shot. And for the 6 pixels here, I'm actually going to offset that at the bottom. And I'm going to do that same sort of a drop shadow on this blue section as well. So let's put in the effect here and we'll pass in the same variables more or less. And we'll also want this to be about 12% rather than 25%. So now we've got a section here for the login that we can utilize. So what I might do is I might actually even put away this section that we had previously. So I'm just gonna put a background box on that so it disappears. And here for these ones, I'm just gonna put this up above. So that's looking a little bit better now. We can give this a title. We can do a couple of different things in it. The first thing I might do is I might stretch it out just a little bit. So it's a little bit longer. We might even put in a logo in here. So I've got an example of their logo and I'm just going to place this above. And what we could do now is we could add some text in here. Maybe something simple like login. We can make this a little bit bigger and we'll want to give this a nice strong primary color. So I'm just going to use that primary color once more here from their logo. We're also going to make this a lot more bold so that it makes a lot of sense. And underneath this section, we can actually use that text that says sign into your account, because now with this global or this main section here that says login, it's a lot easier to see what's actually happening. So I'm going to make this text a little bit smaller here. And what we might do is we'll just move it here underneath the login section and we'll make it a little bit gray, maybe this same sort of gray that we have for the text here for the logo. So that's already looking a lot more clean. The next thing we'll need to do is need to make sure that we have a section here for the input of the username and the password. So usually I like to make this nice and large as well, and we can put this in somewhere here like this. And usually we can pull in maybe a number of things. So we could pull in, for example, the background color here. And we could put another one here for the password. And with these two, sometimes it's even good to be able to have like something that stands out a little bit. So in this case, I might just do a 1 pixel, slightly stronger version here of a border at the top, just so that you guys can see that this is a text input. And we could do that again by copying it and putting one here for the password as well. So let's do that. Here we go. We'll just do that as 1 pixel. And that's looking pretty good. The blue there is a little bit too strong, so I might actually put it at the bottom and that might make a little bit more sense. And I might make it at a 50% opacity. So that way when we hover over it or when we're in an active state, that can get a little bit stronger. The next thing here that I might do is I might move these items up a little bit. So let's grab a couple of these and lock them into place because I don't want them to move anymore. And these ones in here, I'll move up just a little bit just so that they're under the login section there. And we'll add some placeholder text. So in this case, maybe username can go in here. And for this username, we'll also gray it out a little bit. So I'm thinking maybe about 50% opacity, maybe 33%. Maybe that's too little. We'll do 50% and we'll copy this down below and do this for the password as well. So that's looking good. The other thing we could do is maybe even add some icons in here. So to do that, we move them out a little bit and add the icons here on the left. I'll use Font Awesome for this because that's usually quite easy. So in here, I'm just gonna search our password and hopefully this gives me a nice icon here that we can utilize. And there's a few here, so I'm just gonna grab this very first one. And let's download that and we'll put that straight into our Figma board here. We'll resize it down so it's nice and small. And we'll place this slightly above our text input, just over here. The percentage here, I might do 50% as well. So that way, when it's in an active state, it might get a bit more information about what's happening there. Now, the other thing we want to do is also get a user image or icon. So I'm just going to type in user in here, and I'll grab the very first one that seems appropriate. So maybe this one here. And let's also download this one and put that here into our Figma board. Just resize that down again and I'll do about 50% here. And let's just drag that in here. We'll make these maybe a little bit smaller just so they fit in quite well in there. And that way we should be pretty much good now to start using this. So I'm pretty happy with those bits. We can play around with a couple of these things here, like the logo, make that a little bit bigger. We can move up the text just a little bit to give it some better spacing. The other thing we might want to do is create a button because we don't actually have a button yet for logging in. So I'm just going to copy this item here. And for the button, we want this to be a much stronger bit of text that stands out. So what I'll do is I'll do a white color here. I'll do login and this will be very clear. So we'll also maybe make it medium sized. So that way, after you put in your username and password, you clearly can tell that you'll need to press this button to log in. But we need one more thing. We need a sign in section too. And this can be done pretty easily by copying a second button and maybe putting it in below. So normally I like to do something at the very bottom here. This one isn't needing to be as primary. So instead of doing a primary color, we'll just do a primary outline. And then for the text, we might set that as a slight gray because it's a secondary function. So here we'll do register. And we might not even use a primary color for the outline. We might use that secondary color as well. So let's copy that over in here. That way, register new account can be an entirely different button that people can click. And that way it's very useful. Now, one last thing that we really need when we're doing logins is I forgot my password. It might not seem intuitive, but this is something that gets used a lot. So that can be slightly smaller and go something like, I forgot my password. Click here to reset. Great. So we'll put this just underneath and that'll be a hover. Someone can click this and when they hover over, click here, it'll just hover text to create that. So we've got all the elements in here now. I'm gonna move this register section a little bit up above and we can resize these boxes now too. So these ones currently are locked. I'm just gonna resize them now. And everything should have that even sort of padding around. But otherwise, this login box is looking much better now. And if we were to test this out, we would want to do a couple of things here. The other thing I'd like to do is remove this login box at the top here and restyle that with something more primary, such as a register, because registering would be a pretty important aspect. It's almost a call to action in itself. So having that twice on the page is a pretty good idea. And I'd also like to have a second button here that takes me back to the home page. So maybe something like back to home. That makes good sense, I think. And then here, this might be something like a gray color like we had previously. So that way those two buttons are very clear. And what I've done here is I seem to have lost the button I created inside our login box. So I'm just gonna undo that just real quick. So there it is. And I'm gonna paste these in above. So great. We've got our new section here for Thumblytics. And what we have is a nice clear login section. We've got two buttons here at the top for call to actions, but otherwise everything's looking pretty good. And this is my take on a really good login form. If you guys like this, then let me know. But otherwise, I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.